Life in the 21st century can feel like a bit of a letdown. For decades, Hollywood has promised us a world of technology indistinguishable from magic, which we sort of have. But where are the cities full of driverless cars, the handheld lasers, the robotic killing machines who'll stop at nothing to topple their human overlords? Actually, maybe scratch that last one. But the point is, what if all of these and that future are closer than we realize? Take lasers. Now, okay, James Bond-style watches that shoot steel-melting laser beams probably shouldn't be available to the general public. But in less violent forms, lasers are already a feature of gadgets we use every day. And while you might not have noticed their arrival, they could turn out to be the key to many of the science fiction devices we've been promised, thanks to light detection and ranging, or as it's more succinctly called, LiDAR. If you're thinking LiDAR sounds similar to radar, then you're exactly right. In fact, it was developed as the next step up from radar, which works by sending out radio waves to bounce off distant objects, then calculating how far away they are based on how long the signal takes to come back. LiDAR does the same thing, only with laser beams. That might sound like a big jump, because we usually think of radio waves and light as totally different things, but they're not. Both are simply forms of electromagnetic radiation. The only difference is wavelength. Visible light has wavelengths of about 380 to 750 nanometers. We can't see anything above or below that, like the shorter wavelengths of ultraviolet light and X-rays, or the longer ones of radio waves and infrared light, which is what LiDAR uses. Now, obviously, lasers are cool. But the real star of the LiDAR show is the sensor, which needs to be phenomenally accurate. It takes a beam of light about 3.3 nanoseconds, 3 billionths of a second, to make the round trip to an object 50 centimeters away. But the same round trip to an object 52 centimeters away is only 0.1 nanoseconds longer, and a LiDAR sensor can measure that 1/10 billionth of a second difference. The benefit of combining this level of sensitivity with short wavelengths is detail. Think of it like this. A broad brush is great for painting a wall, but with a finer one, you can create an intricate work of art. In the same way, radar's long wavelengths are great for spotting a battleship 50 kilometers away, but the shorter wavelengths of infrared lasers introduce a whole new level of precision, opening the door to all kinds of technologies that can model their surroundings in three dimensions, to navigate and interact with them, even in the dark. Sometimes, this looks just as futuristic as you might expect. Boston Dynamics' running, jumping, parkouring robot Atlas uses LiDAR, for example. And it's also key for developing a technology Hollywood has tantalized us with for years. Autonomous vehicles, which need reliable information about their surroundings for obvious reasons. But this isn't just about the science fiction world of tomorrow. Elsewhere, LiDAR is enhancing more pedestrian technologies. Some robotic vacuums now use it to map, navigate, and clean rooms more efficiently. And LiDAR-equipped phones are putting augmented reality in the palm of your hand. Imagine using your phone to see what a room would look like painted a different color or with different furniture. If you own a phone with LiDAR, you already can. In all kinds of ways, this technology is bridging the gap between the real and digital worlds in ways which have never been possible before. Inevitably, though, it's wise to be cautious. LiDAR creates so many possibilities because it opens up access to a previously untapped dimension of data about our surroundings. But seeing the way information on our tastes, shopping habits, friendships, and movements is harvested, sold, and used against us, it's not hard to see that this new data could lead us into a minefield of new privacy concerns. Once your vacuum has a floor plan of your house, for instance, who else has that information? Could it be used to target you with ads for furniture? In short, yes. And that's just for starters. We haven't even talked about the robot uprising. Either way, it's clear that as LiDAR becomes cheaper and more widespread, we need to be on guard about who's using it and for what. That's going to be increasingly important because LiDAR is one of the innovations closing the gap between what humans and machines can do. We've taken huge strides towards modeling the complexity of human thought, but progress has been much slower in the seemingly simpler realm of building a machine which can cross a room without tripping over. LiDAR is helping to make up the difference. But as we finally approach the world of self-driving cars and domestic robots the movies promised us, we need to be aware of our surroundings to make sure they're changing for the better.